He was considered the ultimate Latin lover, handsome, talented, suave, and muy macho. 1950s Mexican film star Pedro Infante was adored by millions, and in particular idolized by one lonely, misunderstood, and very poetic Texas cowboy, Andreas Castillo. Yo que diera por no ser de ti, pero el día que te dije te quiero, te di mi cariño y no supe de mi corazón. Corazón, no me quieras matar, corazón. Don't let the stars get in your eyes, don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night, in daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes, or keep your heart from me for some.
Well, this is it, sir, the newest sport of them all, the retractable hardtop.
What do you mean, retractable hardtop? It's an open convertible, isn't it?
The top is inside the trunk, sir.
Set in small-town Texas during the Eisenhower years, Amor is the true life tale of one man, one woman, and one community's destiny to fall in love with love. Gone too long, don't forget where you belong. When the stars come out, remember you are mine. Don't let the stars get in your eyes, don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night, in daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes, oh, keep your heart from me, for someday I'll return and you know you're the only one I'll ever love. Can true love exist in a marriage of convenience between the town drunk and the town hooker in order to uphold a conservative community's sense of propriety? Amor is the funny and romantic true life tale of two Mexican-American misfits who find each other just when they resign themselves to the fact love has passed them by. Set in small-town Texas in the repressed 1950s, Andreas Castillo is a rugged local cowboy, a man's man, with the soul of a poet and an obvious drinking problem. Dominga Vargas is a sultry, beautiful woman who's lived hard and played even harder. Returning home to care for her elderly mother, she finds work waitressing and picking up a few extra dollars utilizing the world's oldest profession. Andreas' employer, local rancher Jeff Martin, is forced to deal with Andreas' problems when the town sheriff arrests Andreas one last time for disturbing the peace. On the verge of being sent to the state pen, Andreas confesses that he's miserably lonely, that love has passed him by, and he drinks to forget. When Dominga gets arrested again for solicitation, Roy and Jeff hatch a plan. Marry the two to each other. Dominga is instantly incensed, but for Andreas, it's love at first sight. Forced into the arrangement or risk incarceration in the state pen herself, Dominga reluctantly agrees to the scheme. At first, it's a wretched alliance. Dominga plans her escape with a local Romeo, Narciso, who's only conning her for her money. Jeff's wife, Alberta, is the town do-gooder, and she embarks on a program to teach the two newlyweds to read and write in English, whether they want to or not. Her teenage son, Tommy, falls head over heels in love with high school sweetheart Sharon, and the newly self-assured Andreas, along with some cinematic guidance from the irrepressible Pedro Infante, serves as their romance mentor. In the end, love conquers all, as Dominga comes to realize the deep passion Andreas feels for her, something she's never known, and the community rallies around the couple in a surprising and moving show of support. The moral bestowed, it's not for any of us to say when love has passed us by. Amor will surprise you. Dame más amor, pero más y más. Quiero que me beses como tú me besas y después te vas. Yo comprendo que mi alma en la vida no tiene derecho a querer.